This video will demonstrate how to properly analyze the total chlorine residual of a drinking water sample using the DPD method. This is a basic procedure overview and should not replace or overrule the instructions provided by your equipment manufacturer. You should always analyze samples according to the methods provided by the manufacturer. The method we are following is adapted from standard methods for the examination of water and wastewater. It is used for testing total chlorine, which includes both free and combined chlorine forms found in a drinking water sample. A number of interferences exist for this analysis, and the manufacturer's method should be fully reviewed before starting the test. It is important to review the safety data sheets for the chemicals that are used and to use the recommended personal protective equipment. Power on the instrument. If the instrument you are using is capable of analyzing multiple parameters, select the correct program for the method that you are using. Using the method for reference, locate the correct sample cells for the instrument you are using and note their proper orientation in the instrument. Samples should be collected in clean glass containers or sample cells that have been pre-treated to remove the chlorine demand of the container material. See manufacturer method for details. Sample locations should be flushed to ensure the sample being collected is representative and no headspace should be left above the sample. The sample must be analyzed immediately after collection and cannot be preserved for later analysis as chlorine is a strong oxidizing agent and is unstable. To prepare the blank, rinse and fill the appropriate sample cell to the level indicated with the sample water. Ensure the outside of the cell is fully cleaned and dried to not interfere with your measurement. If the sample cell is significantly scratched, a new cell should be used as this will interfere with your readings. Insert the blank cell into the instrument according to the method instructions. Zero the instrument. Prepare the sample cell by rinsing and filling the sample cell to the level indicated with the sample water. Again, ensure the outside of the cell is fully cleaned, dried, and relatively scratch-free. Add the contents of one pre-measured DPD total chlorine reagent powder pillow. Mix the cell for 20 seconds. Start a timer for 3 minutes and allow the reagent time to react. A pink color will develop with an intensity that is proportional to the concentration of the chlorine in the sample. Within 3 minutes after the timer expires, insert the sample cell into the instrument and read the sample. The results will show in milligrams per liter of chlorine. Ensure the cells are cleaned promptly following analysis as the DPD reagent can permanently stain cells. Dispose all reacted solutions according to applicable regulations. If the sample is over range, it must be diluted and the test must be repeated or another method may be available to measure the sample without dilution. As best practice, a reagent blank should be measured for each new lot of reagent. A reagent blank is completed by replacing the sample water with deionized water and following the same method for analysis. If a value is obtained, it can be subtracted from the sample results to minimize the interference caused by the reagent. This method can be verified at any time using a known standard to confirm the instrument readings are accurate. Manufacturer's instructions should be followed for this procedure. It is important to note that if free and total chlorine are both being analyzed by an operator, different, dedicated cells should be used for each method. This is because trace DPD reagent can be carried over and will interfere with your residual chlorine readings. For more information about our courses or to schedule an on-site delivery, visit www.wcwc.ca/registration or contact staff directly at 1-866-515-0550.